It's surprising, really, how casually we treat this life-giving liquid. Most of us assume we can always get some more from a tap or buy it in a bottle. And around the world, we're prepared to waste billions of litres of this stuff every day. But how can we stop squandering this vital natural resource? Well, the people strolling around this plaza here may actually be part of the solution, with their daily contributions to an unusual experiment on the outskirts of town.
Every time someone in Melipilla flushes a toilet, the wastewater ends up at the University of Chile's nearby wastewater treatment plant. This pilot plant is comparing the efficiency and cost of the old system of a settlement pond to a new Chilean invention, an ecological biofilter system. The new system is treating the domestic wastewater of 1,000 locals at a rate of 1,000 litres of sewage per square metre, twice as fast as the conventional system. Human and industrial wastewater are the main sources of global pollution, contaminating both water and soil. Most of us never see wastewater, but it's barely recognisable and, before being treated, decidedly unhealthy.
The problem with existing treatment plants like this one is that they're slow, they require continual maintenance, they take up an awful lot of land space and plenty of energy. As well as that, the chlorine, which is added as a disinfectant towards the end of the process, can combine with nitrogen to form a harmful chemical compound. This is then pumped out into river systems and the sea, creating a potential environmental hazard. And of course, if you've ever lived or worked anywhere near one of these plants, you'll be only too familiar with the distinctive and highly unpleasant odour.
First, wastewater is sent through a biological filter.
The wastewater containing suspended solids and organic matter is scattered over a layer of humus or soil containing billions of microorganisms, as well as tens of thousands of these, Eisenia, a species of common earthworm that coexist with the microbes. Together, they form a natural partnership. The microbes break down the liquid and solid wastes, and the worms feed off the microbes. In return, as the worms move through the soil, they create pathways, allowing air to circulate and introducing oxygen, which the microbes need in order to stay alive.
All this results in reducing the number of organic compounds in the outflow by an incredible 96%. The second stage is an electromagnetic process to eliminate the rest of the microorganisms from the biofilter discharge.
If you look under here, you'll see there are five ultraviolet fluorescent tubes. Well, as the water passes through the shallow basin, it's irradiated by the UV beams, and that kills all the remaining microorganisms. So then the water is fully treated and can safely be recycled for agriculture or industry.
The system is claimed to be 100% successful. Before irradiation, there are still 10 to the 5 fecal coliforms per 100 millilitres in the water, a very harmful brew. But afterwards, there are none. The purification is only possible because the water is so clear after the worms have done their work. If it contained any solids or was murky and opaque, the UV beams would be absorbed and fail in their task. Dr. Jose Toja from the University of Chile's Physics Department runs the experiment and is very happy with the results.
This is good for 1,000 people. The treatment is quick and the consumption of the organic material is totally aerobic. The system can be used anywhere.
The biofilter's next task is to clean industrial organic wastes from local fisheries, slaughterhouses and dairies. Those worms have got a lot of work to do.